Hey, it's been a long time, I know. I even said I wasn't going to do these anymore, but I was thinking about it lately, and I know how Jay Grubgun, he likes doing when I do these, so I thought it might be worthwhile. I got some stuff since then. Not really all old, more actually newer stuff for the PlayStation 4, but that's just how it works more and more all the time, as I've said, I know, many times before and probably last time. Coming across what I want and what I would like to see is not something that happens as much as it used to, or, you know, you just gotta deal with what you get, and that's part of the problem. But anyway, I got good stuff, of course, and some really good stuff, and, well, yeah, just gonna do it like usual. I'm gonna try not to go on forever, but we'll see what happens, and, of course, as always, action style, because that's how I prefer it. Anyway, so, hey, I'm here. Oh, wait, I can't use that. That's his saying. Anyway, so we're gonna do the old stuff first, because I think that's a better way to do it, because I know for the longest time all of you watch me, that's what you're more interested in, let's be honest. So we're gonna start off, and if I've showed any of this like in the last time, whenever, how long ago was I did this, I just didn't remember, I looked to make sure, but I might have overlooked something. Anyway, so and if I left anything out, that's a mistake too. Anyway, we're going to start off with something really great, and something I was kind of shocked to find in person, let alone in really good shape, and the battery works and all that. This is something I didn't expect I'd be able to get again in person at all, or let alone what I got it for, which was actually slightly below eBay price, which is kind of ridiculous itself. Anyway, because I don't get Super Nintendo games all that much anymore because of what they cost, and I'd rather use that money for the Saturn, which I do have two things to show for the Saturn. Anyway. So yeah, I don't think I need to say anything about this, do I? Super Mario RPG, Legend of the Seven Stars, sorry. Great RPG, of course, and one, once again, Europe was screwed over and not getting until the Virtual Console. I've always liked this one a lot. I actually didn't even bother playing on the emulator because I wanted to get the real thing again, and well, here it is. I'm still working through it. There's many long games I'm trying to play through at the same time, so progress is slow, but still, it's nice to go into now and then. I also have Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, the first one again on the Advance, and it's kind of a similar game, so in a way I was already playing this before I got it again, but this was something I really couldn't resist getting once I saw it, and well, take the chances when you get it, let's put it that way. I got it at a place I usually don't like getting old stuff from, because the prices are kind of whack, let's put it that way. Speaking of, the next one is actually from the same place. And this is another one I didn't expect to be able to come by anytime soon either. And fortunately, unlike some other Genesis Mega Drive games, I actually got the damn manual with this one, so it's complete. Hooray! I love Wolf Team, as I've mentioned before, and pretty much all their games. And this is a really cool one itself. Final Zone. Always liked it a lot. It's a really fun mech game. I like my mechs and my robots and all that kind of stuff. It's a cool one if you've never played it, definitely recommend it. Takes a while to get used to, but it's cool how you can swap all different kind of weapons for the different arms and all that. It's like Armored Core Lite, in a way. Sort of. You can't customize the robot itself, but whatever. It's a fun one. Axis still beats my ass, that's the end boss, but whatever. Eh, a little stiff. Anyway, but there you go. Manual's in there, and the cartridge is in very good shape too. The label's not coming off, which is always nice. No poster with this one, unfortunately. Anymore, I hope even when I don't get the manual, it has a poster in it, but that doesn't always happen. Still, either way, it's nice to have another Wolf Team back game back again, because originally I only had this loose, so now I have the box and the manual. Alright, next, moving up. This is one I'm really tired of hearing the same shit over and over. Well, I mean really on Twitter, because that's where I spend most of my time having fun instead of YouTube doing videos, but I don't agree with most people. Let me put it this way. There's far worse Sonic games that have come out, and 2D or 3D, this is nowhere near even remotely the worst Sonic game, okay? Just join reality and realize that some need to do. It's ridiculous. Anyway, the Saturn version is superior. Sonic 3D Blast, or as it's known, not in North America, Flicky's Island. I prefer 3D Blast, it just sounds funnier. Sounds like some kind of crappy cereal. Anyway, yeah, so I got this back again, and it is complete. Box is rough, but that's the way the cardboard ones are. But I've seen worse cardboard box games for it, so that's not the bad. There's the manual in there. I'm not going to try and take all that out. What's the point? You know what the damn manual looks like. It's just a manual. It's not even color. Anyway, all works fine. The box, like I said, I've seen worse shape, but eh. I've always liked 3D Blast a good amount. Again, the Saturn version is better, but the Genesis Mega Drive version is fun enough itself. It plays fine. Controls hell of a lot better than so many of the other recent Sonic games. You want me to go for the bad ones? I can. Including recent ones like Sonic Forces. I was very unimpressed with what I saw, and even less impressed once it came out. I Have Mania, need to get back to it. That's actually a good game. Also, it's not 3D. Anyway, this is isometric, but whatever. I like it. Music's pretty cool in it, too. Made by Traveler's Tales, they're the developer. So, sometimes I think it's funny when I think back to that's what they did in this. But, yeah, I'm pretty sure you're familiar with this one. All I need now, again, is Spinball, and then my Sonic Genesis Mega Drive set is complete, once again. Which I keep seeing Spinball for not really all that much what you can get for these days, at least for me. But I keep passing over to get other stuff. I don't know why. Hey, at least it's easy to come by. Okay, so, actually doing better on time than I thought. Now, this is one I was really glad to get again, even though I prefer the second one, like most. Manual's missing, sadly, but again, I gotta take my chances what I can get. I don't need to say much about this either. We all know it. Road Rash, yay, the first one. And he's being a real dick to that guy, knocking him over. He's gonna get points on his license. Yeah, always a fun game to play, of course. Again, I prefer the second one just for little things, but the first one's just as fun, really. The third one I like too, just not as much. In fact, the order for me, if you're curious, is 2, 1, 3. Of the original three versions, that is only going with the Genesis Mega Drive ones too. Because this, of course, later on, not exactly the same, came on the Sega CD, the PlayStation, the 3DO, and blah, blah, blah. But yeah, it's nice to have this one again. Was hoping to get the second one even more, but yeah, I'll go in order, why not? And like I said, I hate it when that happens. It doesn't really hold in there well. The manual's missing, but everything else is in nice shape, so I can't complain with that, and it works perfectly fine. Because that's what really matters in the end. Okay, so here's another heavy hitter, and really a must-have for the Saturn, let's be honest. I like it quite a lot, don't get me wrong, but I've never been huge on it like some are. But it's nice to get again, and yet again, because it's just how it worked for me. While I would have preferred to have the normal for American version like I had originally, I gotta take what I can get, so it's a Japanese version. It doesn't bother me at all. But fortunately, because I actually plan on doing this intentionally, I came across this, I already have the 3D controller for the Saturn, because that's the best way to play it, which you should already know what this is by now, because of what I just said. Nights in the Dreams, and I was really happy with how what it was going for, so I had to jump on it. It was the best game I saw there that day. The Saturn games are kind of running dry for me lately, finding them in person, Japanese or North American or whatever. But this was a nice one to come by again. And again, while I'd rather have the North American version, it is nice seeing the alternate look of the Japanese case here. Oddly, I do just as well in it as I used to. In fact, even without playing it for so long, even emulated, I still remember how to deal with the bosses. It's weird how I can memorize some things like that without even trying, and other things I just forgot. Like this one. I don't know. But anyway, of course, always a fun game, made by Sonic Team. So there's two Sonic-related things I'm showing here. And, yeah, I'm pretty sure you already know about this. Don't know if I'm going to bother getting Christmas Nights, though. I've seen what it goes for. I just can't be bothered. I'll use Pseudo-Saturn if I feel the need, but I never really did. Christmas Nights is alright. I played around with it before in the past, but I'd rather just mess around with the actual main game here. So, there's that. Also, I've never played it on anything but the Saturn, so I still prefer the original version. Despite, you know, everyone says, it's better than the Xbox 360. When I had an Xbox 360, I didn't get it for that. Because I just didn't know it came out for it until later on. I just noticed. Oh, I did have Guardian Heroes for it, though. Which I still prefer originally on the Saturn for that, too. Which I do have again, but I showed that way back when I got it. Anyway, this one is complete, of course, but... I don't care. My stuff always goes along. I want to spend time looking at this. So here we have one of the little cool extras. It's just like showing you stuff you can get. Of course, it's all in Japanese kanji, so good luck reading that. I know one person who could read it, Anthony, if you watch my stuff still. You'll know what all this jargon is. There's the cool Bomberman Saturn controller. Be nice to have that just to have, but I like Bomberman a lot. And you can see what some of the other games are. I know what these are, just going by the pictures, but... It would be nice to read them, of course. There's a game I never could get into, Decathlete or whatever. And some... non-game stuff, but it's accessories or whatever. I don't know. I don't feel like going into that. I talk about that enough elsewhere. Virtual Fighter Kids, very good game, but the chibi look of it kind of put me off, I'll be honest. Normally that doesn't happen, but in that case it did, to this day. And of course there's the manual. I think I have the other thing in it too, and I just put it in here so it doesn't flop around. Or no. Okay, it was just that. But yeah. This is another thing that's kind of nice to see, is because the Japanese manual is different, of course, to what the North American one was. Slightly different pictures. Oh yeah, there it is. Okay. I did stick it in here. So here's the other thing that was in it. And of course, in Japan, the 3D controller is gray, slightly different colored buttons, but I'm okay with mine matching what actual system I have, which is the North American one, black. I still kind of prefer the Saturn in black. That's what I've been used to for so long, since the 90s. Oh yeah, and of course, here's the disc, which I like the look of it on there. So that's nice. Now that's always been a cool picture. I have a really good resolution version of that I use as a wallpaper sometimes on the computer when I feel like it. It just looks really nice with the colors and all that. Actually, this is going to sound strange, but it reminds me of Sonic Unleashed. The way Knights looked in that. Knights, not the name of this. Had the same kind of look and feel to it. Alright, so last Saturn game, the last old game to show here. Well, I say last old game. I do have a remaster, but we'll get to that. It's not that old. It came out in 2006 originally. Okay, so I want to... I'm going to be boring with this, but I want to. I can't help it. I want to explain some things and talk about why I got it and blah, 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 blah. I did that on Twitters, and I featured it. Anyway, The Tower. Some of you might actually know what this is just by looking at the picture or even just guessing. I've been interested in it for the Saturn for quite some time. It's not just for the Saturn. There's also on the Game Boy Advance called The Tower SP, which I'd like to get it for that because I have a micro and I can play it. I'm trying to figure out how to do this without actually having notes. I did it all in there. It's originally called Utes Tower, because it's named after the guy who came up with it. I'm bad with names, especially when it's, you know, a Japanese name, so don't even try. But Utes Tower was on the computer and all that. There's also a sequel, sort of, that came out later on after that. Wasn't as great, but whatever. The original here, The Tower. Not the original version of it, or at least for me. Now, many of you probably know it by this name better. Sim Tower. Yes, when it came out in North America, Maxis put it out, and it was called Sim Tower. For all intents and purposes, the same game, except on the Saturn here, this actually has a little bit more going on than this. I still prefer to play on this just because of mouse and keyboard, I'm used to it. This, however, a little more flashy. You actually get animated videos when you inspect, like, the different offices or condos or whatever the frick else, different restaurants. You also have a lot more stuff you can choose, and some of it is very specifically Japanese style, which is kind of cool, and of course, that's the idea here. Only came out in Japan for the Saturn, which, you know, how many times have I said that? This, at least, came out in North America and Europe. This was only in Japan for the Saturn. This is the cheapest Saturn game I've gotten in, I can't remember how long, by the way, on eBay, no less. Exactly $10. Free shipping. From Japan. I wish I could get good Saturn games like this that cheap all the time. In person, especially, but that ain't gonna happen. I'm living in a fairy tale land. Anyway, so the real reason I wanted to get it for the Saturn, just out of curiosity, is because, well, I've tried and I give up on getting this to work anymore. The last time I got this to work on the computer was Windows 7. Ever since, it's been nothing but hell, and it just won't even, can't do it. This isn't the DOS version, which doesn't help me. Now, if it was DOS, I could just use DOSBox, but I can't. So, oh well, it's another useless coaster. This, though, does work, and really good. I wasn't really big on the idea of playing it with a controller, and I'm still getting used to it, but it works perfectly fine enough, and it works really well on the Saturn. A couple other cool things I want to mention. I mean, it might help if I showed it, but I don't feel like going to that point and recording it just to stick it in here. It's not that big of a deal. One cool thing, another addition you can have, like I said, there's little videos when you inspect the condos and such, is you can actually put a video billboard on the outside of your tower or building once it's big enough, and it'll actually show real commercials. Japanese commercials, of course. Like, there's one for Suzuki. There's actually a couple of car ones. There's another one for some kind of, like, I think perfume or something like that. I don't know. The lady seems happy, so I'm guessing it's good. It's kind of cool to see that. And it's a little bit interesting. It makes the things a little bit more, I guess, exciting than just how the computer version I just showed you was. But I still had a lot of fun with it. I've always liked The Tower or Sim Tower, whichever you prefer to call it, a lot. I'm not joking. As much as I love Sim City, and I do like Sim City a lot, I really do. In some ways, I had more fun doing this because, well, instead of managing an entire city, you're just managing an entire building, which in some ways is a little trickier because you got to get things just right and all that, especially when you're starting off. It's pretty cool. Also, just to mention it, different times of day, you'll actually see different little GIF videos for when you examine things. It's pretty cool. And if there's a lot of people in a restaurant, for example, you'll actually see more people. They have a video just for that to show that there's a lot more people in there. Or if it's like a really shitty day, there's no one in it. I like things like that. It's little details. It's pretty cool. Also, everything else just has a lot more detail to it than, say, like the computer version I just showed you. But whatever. Runs really well in the Saturn, too. Even when you have a lot of shit going on, it doesn't really slow up or anything. Now, one of the areas, again, that's a problem because you can't read Japanese or anything like that. And I've never played it on the controller, let alone the Saturn controller. I still can't find out how you speed up time or slow it down. I've tried every combination on the buttons I can think of. I know it's there. I just can't figure it out. In an attempt to figure that out, I actually played the advanced version on the emulator to see if it might have been similar to this, and I tried to duplicate it. Apparently it doesn't. I'm going to figure it out eventually, or I'll find someone who's translated the damn manual for this. Anyway, all that said and done, I do highly recommend the Japanese-only release Saturn version here. It's very, very good. Also, we got more to talk about. Also, I could have showed you the picture so you can see what I'm talking about here. It doesn't show the videos, but you see it's nicely detailed in the building and all. So, again, if you played SimTower, you know exactly what this is like. Now, something you might be wondering is, why in the hell does it have one of these dual CD case things? Is it a multi-disc game? Because, I'll tell you right now, the computer version wasn't. No. This is something I don't understand either. As much as I've looked into stuff, I've read stuff, and I know about things, this is something I never could comprehend to this day, and I've never heard anyone mention it else, so I guess no one else cares to know like me. Some games were released like this. I don't mean just Japan only or Saturn. I've seen PlayStation games that came out in a dual thing like this, but don't have any more than one disc that they run on. I don't get it. This is the way the game came. It's not a replacement case either. I don't know. I mean, it's nice to put this little extra shit in there so it doesn't get lost, but whatever. And there's, warranty card or something like that. Also had the spine. To keep it nice, I put it in here and see a few more pictures for it. Yes. Open book. Might know what that is. I don't feel like explaining it. Anyway. I have a lot of ads for this, too. I collect ads for mostly Sega stuff, and they're pretty cool looking. Oh, damn it, it happened again. Probably because I was shaking it around. This looks cool. Reminds me of Home Alone. You know, the intro, how it shows the skyline. And there's the manual, of course, which is fairly thick, and I can't read a friggin' thing of it. Which, it tells me in here how to do the speed up time thing, but even just trying to muddle through it, I can't figure out where it is in here. I'm going to figure it out eventually. It's the only thing left I really need because it sucks sitting there waiting and waiting and waiting. But a good thing is they actually coded this right for the Saturn. The disc will stop spinning until it needs to again. So you're not going to wear the damn thing out. I had it going for like 10 hours. I just went off and did other things on the weekend. I wanted to see how things would go. I made a lot of money in this. Let me tell you. In fact, that's the save I'm going to probably continue on later on. Anyway, so that's the old stuff out of the way. Now let's go on about the new stuff, and I won't drag on as much, hopefully. This is one I'm not sure if I showed the last time I did one of these, by the way. Very good game. I actually played the demo for it, because I've always done this. I did it on the PlayStation 3, I did it on Xbox 360, supplement games, like not having a lot of games for a new system when I get it. And then just to see what I'm curious for, I actually have a few more I'm trying to get around to. Tried one for a game called Gravel. It's an off-road racing game, because all the friggin' ones that come out anymore are off-road games. Not exactly the kind of racing game I want, but it's a good one, just saying. So, this is one I played for demo for quite a while, and I liked it a lot, and I finally got it because I wanted to get rid of a certain other game that I finally was willing to take a chance on, and it was absolute shit. I don't even want to talk about it, but this is what I got when I traded that back in, and I could afford to get this, Grand Kingdom. It's a pretty cool game. It's like a cross between a type of strategy game and RPG. It's got both of those elements into it. Active kind of battle system. It's probably easier if you saw a video of what it's like, but, I like how it works, is all you need to know. It's a fun game. I need to get back to it. I'm distracted by certain other games for the PlayStation 4 right now. But I keep jumping back into this one and some others. But it's a fun game. Definitely recommend it. The English translation... English translation isn't the best. As I mess up trying to say it myself. And it's kind of... got that cringe thing going on to it. But I can overlook it. I'm just saying. Also, there's an advertisement for some other kind of game. But Grand Kingdom is a fun one. Not one I hear anyone really mention for the PlayStation 4 or whatever. It's also on the Vita. But yeah, I like it. Check it out. Now, this is another one which I'm pretty sure many of you know. I was thinking about getting it for quite a while, and I finally did. And I have some of the... it comes with essentially what they call Season 1 tables on this, but you have to pay to get the rest. And there's certain ones I like, and I got, like... it wasn't included in this, but it actually has one of my favorite tables in this already, is Taxi by Williams. In fact, most of my favorite pinball tables are from Williams. Another one by them, which is pretty much my favorite, Bram Stoker's Dracula, based on the movie, Francis Ford Coppola's. I had to get that one separately, so I got that. I also got the Addams Family pinball table, which is fantastic. Goes for a lot of money, too, the real table. and one or two others. But it's a great game overall. It's amazing the little details they put in here. Oh, and they also put the Stern, the new one that came out only a few years ago, the Ghostbusters table. So I already love playing that at the one place I can go to for arcade games still. Now I actually have it to play here, all I want. But even better, the one they have at that place is not the top-of-the-line premium one. In this, you can only get the premium one. So that's pretty cool. Slightly different artwork and all that, but the game works pretty much the same. I think of it as practice for when I do the real one, because I don't have to put quarters in to play this one if I want to keep trying over and over and over. You know, to practice at. But anyway, some of the other tables too that I've never played the real version of are really cool in this. So overall, I just really like this a lot. It's great. I had Pinball FX, the first one for the PlayStation 3 on PSN, and it was very good too with the physics and all that. The reason I'm bringing it up is I'm not trying to do comparison. I think it's pretty much about as good, if not slightly better, in this one. But as just overall how they go about this, I think it's a lot better. But you can see some of the ones that are in Season 1, as they call it. Again, that's what this pretty much is on disc. Otherwise, it's a free thing. You can get on PSN, and then you have to pay for the rest. It's also on the computer, on Steam, and Xbox One, and blah, blah, blah. It's even on freaking tablets. Anyway, I just love all the different tables that they put in here. And, yeah, it's just really nice, because some of these I have played the real thing of, and I like quite a lot, but other ones are too old, and I just can't come across, like Black Hole, which is really cool, Twilight Zone, which is a fun one. And you got some other ones, like the one Elvira one I have played in person, Scared Stiff, but the other one I never did, which is the Party Monsters, which I think is actually slightly better, given certain things. Old tables are different, of course, but it's nice. I was really surprised by the inclusion of the Ghostbusters one, because I wasn't expecting that, because there is a different one of this. It's only for Stern. There's Jack really for it. I don't know why he would bother. He should have just included it in this one. Something I know I'm dragging on, this is going along and I want to, but there's something else I want to mention because it's my video. I find kind of odd. There are some Sega and Data East tables in this without Sega or Data East's names on it. So it's one of those weird things where they technically got permission, but they didn't get permission. I don't understand. Unless the licenses lapse for those, like Universal, I think, owns Starship Troopers. That's one you can get for this. But Sega put it out originally. I have the flyers to prove it. And Sega's name is missing from this. There's a couple of Data East tables too, and it's just blank, no name. It's kind of strange. It doesn't even mention it when you read the, like, the description, which that's a cool thing too. It gives you like a little history, tells you how many were made, and anything unique about it, and also the designers and blah blah blah. It's really cool how they went about this. It's like it's a very, very nice little thing, and I appreciate the effort that Farsight made in this. It's really cool, and they actually have a little thing saying how they really strive to get accurate, just like as close as you could imagine playing the actual table. It was the goal. Had, like, the sounds, the lights, and all that. You can actually customize stuff like that, too, and choose your own pinballs, which I like the Ghostbusters one, so now I use that for everything. You can buy more pinball balls, too. I want to mention something real quick, too. When it comes to prices, I find it a little weird what some of them are, because certain individual tables, I think, are a little way too much. Like, the Ghostbusters one was pretty much 10. Yeah. I usually wouldn't do that kind of thing, but I love the table so much, I had to have it. But then you got others where you get a couple together and the price is a little bit better, but then there's some other ones where you get like only one or two. And then it's weird how there's certain ones you can only get them with another one. Like, it comes with Bride of Pinbot, which is the second one of that series. But if you want actual original Pinbot, you can get it, but you have to get it with another one. Which I've tried both. I've tried the other table that it comes with. It's pretty good, but why can't you just get Pinbot? It's one of the most famous tables ever. I don't get it. There's also the third one. I can't remember what that one's called. Bride of Pinbot, by the way, is fantastic. I'm so close to getting the Wizard Goals on that. Ooh. Also, that's something else cool. You get normal goals, and then once you complete all five of those, then you get Wizard Goals, which are obviously a lot more harder. And again, not all tables are the same, so some are much harder or easier than others. And some I do a lot better with others than certain ones. I don't know why. Don't ask me. But it's just so much fun. It's really good. God, talking about pinball, every time I want to do it, I want to play it. I got to get my own table someday. Gotta. Well, fortunately, the ones I want cost a little too much. Bram Stoker's Dracula is within reach. Anyway, so this one, I really don't have jack to say. I talked about it various streams and all that. Yeah, I finally got Grand Theft Auto 5. I got sick and tired. It went down slightly. Should be down more, given how long it's been out. I don't give a fuck about stupid online thing. Or paying what they want for PlayStation Plus. It's ridiculous. It's going up even more than when it first came out. Anyway, Grand Theft Auto 5. I can say right now, even though I'm not done with it yet, I do like it far more than 4. I'm not bored with it. I don't despise it. I don't want to give up on it. I'm just, again, distracted by other games I'm playing. Also, I just realized this residue left from the sticker looks a little bit like some kind of weird dolphin alien fish. Whatever. Anyway, yeah, five I like. Of the three characters, I like Michael because, and I looked this up because I started noticing similarities. Apparently, I'm right. There are a lot of coincidences to him and Tony Soprano, so it amuses me. Then I just find his family life a little humorous to what's going on. He pulls a Martin Riggs thing, was it in Lethal Weapon 2, where he pulls down that house? You actually do that in one mission. So that's pretty cool. Overall, I like it. The little details and all kind of stuff. There are certain things about the kind of, it's still doing the same kind of thing like Grand Theft Auto 4. I want it to go back to the way it used to be with, like, Vice City. That's why it's my favorite one. It needs to be a lot less serious. That's why I got to liking Saints Row the Third as much as I did, because it reminds me of old Grand Theft Auto before 4, basically like San Andreas back. It was not taking itself seriously. This still takes itself too seriously, but at the same time, I see a little bit of the old humor back in this, especially with characters like Trevor and all that. But even then, just messing around doing what you want, which is the only real way I have fun in Grand Theft Auto, like most people. I don't really give a shit about the story. You get a little bit of that back. And I wasn't expecting that, so that's nice. There's also another little things you couldn't do in this that weren't in 4 and all that, where you can, like, actually go to movie theaters now and watch stuff. Like, that weird, like, art film movie that's in Spanish. I like watching that one. It's great. Anyway, I got this used, obviously, but it actually had the map and all that, so that's nice. I like getting the maps with the Grand Theft Auto games. It's cool. Which, by the way, yes, I am looking forward to Red Dead Redemption 2. I'm going to have a lot more fun with that than this because, well, I'm just into Western stuff. I do like 5, but I can tell you right now, I don't see myself spending as much time with it as I have since it was new with Vice City. It's just one of those kind of things. I do like it, though. Okay, next up. Batman Arkham Knight. Need to get back to this one, too. I like it quite a lot. Didn't get it on the computer because they fucked up the computer version, and to this day, it's still not really right what it should be. Anyway, now I got that out of the way. Like this quite a lot, even more than I thought, because Arkham Asylum is my favorite. I like City. It's not my favorite like most people says. Didn't want nothing to do with Origins because, well, it's on principle. I refuse to give them money for it after what they pulled. This one, though, a lot more interesting. For one, you get to use the Batmobile, which it reminds me too much of the Nolan movie ones, which I don't want to call it a Batmobile. I don't really want to call this a Batmobile either. It's more like a tank. But I do like it. It's pretty fun. And it's interesting how they turned the Batmobile into a kind of a character in this. It's almost like a sidekick, like Robin. Well, okay, it's a vehicle, but whatever. It's like, I don't know, it's like Bumblebee, I guess, or Herbie. You can call it in remote control. It's got a cannon on it, a machine gun, but it automatically switches over to tranquilizer darts when you're shooting at people. See? Batman still don't kill people. That's the rule. Anyway, it's a cool thing. The design of it, at the same time, I do think is pretty interesting. But there is a sort of mini-game alternate side mode you can do in this where you can race around in Riddler's nutty friggin' Hot Wheels-like tracks. And you can get actual Batmobiles. You can get the Michael Keaton 1989 one, which I actually bought. And once you beat the game, you can free drive around in that. But it doesn't have the certain equipment in it, so you can't actually use it in the main game. That was disappointing when I found out, but whatever. I understand. Oops, sorry. Whack the tripod. I'm not used to this. I haven't done this in a while. You can also get the original 60s Batman, you know, Adam West and Robin there. I got to get that one eventually. It's going to be pretty cool to see. And you get two tracks that are themed after one, like, say, again, the 1989 one. You get, I can't remember what the first one was actually based on, but around the area, but the second one, you get to go through, like, Penguin's thing and all that. You see the ducky mobile he had and all. It's pretty cool. Anyway, the game itself, very fun. I mean, it's the Arkham series. Most people are tired of it by now. I'm not really. Definitely like this, certain elements of this, even more than City, by the way. Certain things about the story and all that. There's certain other quirks to it I could live without. Almost at the part where I fight Deathstroke now, which I'm really looking forward to. I need to get back to this, but I'm trying to see, the problem is with a lot of these games, I'm trying to do every little thing I possibly can, and it's really taken a long time to do that. But I'm okay with it. I'm going about it my way, I'm having fun the way I want to. That's the main point here. Speaking of games where there's a shit ton of things to do that aren't part of the main game, I'll show both of these at the same time, even though one I got before the other. I've been all over the place with this series, but it's really good and I like it a lot. And, well, there's not much I can complain about. It's fantastic. First up, I got this for 20, actually. I couldn't resist when I saw it. Yakuza Kiwami, which means extreme. This is pretty much the first Yakuza remade. And since this has been a long-ass time, I thought it was a good way to re-experience it. Even then, I just, you know, I wanted to get it because it's a fun game. Really like it a lot. I put this on hold because of another one. This is one of the more recent games I've got in general. Yakuza 0, which is fantastic. This is a new game, not a remake. And this is well, as the name implies, goes all the way back to the beginning here in 1988 Japan. It's so much fun playing OutRun in this. Anyway, it's great. And there are certain differences between the two. I mean, for one, I like getting weapons out easier in this than that. You gotta do a combination with this. All you do in this is push down the D-pad. Anyway, both are great games. Once I'm done with these, I want to move on to Kiwami 2, which again is a remake of 2. But then there's also the newest new one, Yakuza 6, which is looking ridiculously awesome. In fact, I might just go to that one first, then get Kiwami 2 whenever down the line. But this is great games. It's so much fun beating the living crap out of people and going bar hopping and whatever else. And I've already found one of my favorite side submissions in this, where you get to collect these telephone cards, and once you have enough of those, you can watch an erotic video of some whatever lady. But I thought something would happen if you keep going in there over and over and over, and eventually does, and you have to help this guy meet one of the girls that's in the video he obsesses about watching. I don't want to ruin it because it gets really crazy after that and certain choices you make, but it's great. Yakuza 0, I think, personally, is better than this. Nothing against it, because remember, this is a remake of the first one, so it is technically an old game. The first one came out, was it 2005 or 6? For the PlayStation 2? It's still a good game, but underneath, some of the oldness still persists. This one, though, just for certain few other design decisions and all that, also it's kind of cool just to go all the way back to see, you know, the start of all of it with Kira and all that. I like it more. Gameplay-wise, mechanic-wise, I think this is a lot better than Kiwami. But I still like Kiwami, don't get me wrong. I just wanted to throw that in there. Someone else who I talked to is huge into Yakuza. He pretty much agrees. Right? He likes Zero more, too, for kind of the same reasons I said, which I can understand. And it's cool to go back to the 80s, of course. There's a lot of Sega-ness in this. I like collecting, doing the little UFO catcher things. You can get a stuffed Mega Drive, and you can also get Opa Opa. Of course, I had to get both of those for my collection. Anyway, so we got two more here, and I'll save the better game for last. Now, I don't want to go on about this one really a lot, because I've already hit 30-some minutes, which is ridiculous, but there is something specific I want to say with this. It's kind of a complaint, but it's not with the game itself, or maybe it could be. It depends on how you consider it. I haven't done a lot with this since I got it yet, but I've done some things. I've been interested in this for a while since it was announced, but I knew I didn't want to bother with it until it was much less. I got this for $13 at a place I didn't even think video games were sold. Anyway, also the same place where I got Batman Arkham Knight, by the way. Far Cry Primal, I think, is interesting because, for one, no guns. I'm tired of guns all the time. It's nice to play something that you don't use that, and I was looking forward to using the bow and all that, which is fun. Not much I can complain about. I mean, it's Far Cry. There are differences with this. It's kind of cool. The whole crafting and all that kind of stuff makes a lot of sense in this one, given, well, how far back it goes. The story, as so far I got into it, is pretty interesting. I like it. I like where it's going with it and the whole idea of uniting tribes and blah, blah, blah. But there is a unique problem I've discovered with this, and in my own lifetime of playing video games, 2D, 3D, bad, good, great, whatever, I've only come across this a few times, and I'm more sure it's a problem with myself, my eyes, than the game. It's impressive how dense they can make the foliage in this, and the forest, and the trees, and the grass, and all, you know, foliage. However, it fucks with my vision like no tomorrow. I cannot see anything. I can't see enemies. I can't see things to collect. I can't see animals. I can't see anything. The only way I can pretty much play this and do anything is to 99% of the time use this hunter vision thing, which makes the world grayscale and highlights things in a very in-your-face way. Now, at the same time, I think it might also be a problem with the game itself because of how dense everything is and how everything just blends together like natural camouflage, and my vision isn't that great, so it's kind of a problem. I also think it might be an issue that because I'm not playing on the computer, where you're closer to a screen, of course, with the monitor, the way you play on a computer, and versus on the PlayStation 4 with TV, which I'm not really that far from it, but it's enough. And of course, on the computer, you can make things look better than on a console and play around with things. You can't do it on that. I think that's the problem. It's a twofold thing. I think it's more down to my vision is not great than that, but it's very few games I've come across that I've played where that's an issue, and it's one in this, and it's kind of annoying. So I have to play the game in grayscale, essentially, so I can just find and see anything. Otherwise, I'll just get killed, and I don't even know where I'm being attacked from. It's an unfortunate thing. I like the game, but at the same time, what I'm getting at is I do kind of wish I was willing to put up with Uplay again and got it for the computer so I could see. Now, I'm not saying I'm going to do this, but I am considering maybe I might trade this in, use it towards something else. And when I see it on sale on Uplay or something, I'll get it for the computer. Because I'm pretty sure that problem will be fixed. And, you know, it would be nice to play the game in color. It's also kind of why I haven't done a lot with it until I could figure out, or maybe I'm just, I don't know. It's a little bit of an annoying thing, and it kind of looks dumb playing it like that, but it's a very unique issue I've only come across a few times in my entire life. And it's never been on the computer. I should mention, too, any game I play on the computer. There was one, but there was a way to fix it. So, I don't know. That's something I wanted to mention, because, I don't know, I thought it was worth mentioning. Alright, last up, not a ton to say about this, because everyone knows about it, and it's a game I absolutely love. It's one of my favorite games I had on the PlayStation 2. Might not be what you call the hardest game ever, but it's a fantastic game with a really cool look to it, of course, and the story is, you know, it's really, really good. Another very, very Japanese game here. Okami HD, yes. Great. Nothing I could complain about with this re-release of it, remaster, whatever. I've mentioned this before, I put a disclaimer, I've said this long ago, and I keep repeating it because it bears repeating, because I always have to repeat myself. I said that there are exceptions I make to the whole remaster remake thing, because generally I can't stand it, I'm sick and tired of it, we get too many of them these days, I stand by that, and I still do. As much as I like this, at the same time, I'm sick and tired of remakes. I like this too, but we get way too much of it in this generation. This is the remake remaster generation, and it's getting a little ridiculous. But this is one I'm okay with, because while it already looked great on the PlayStation 2 and Wii, I had it on the PlayStation 2, whatever, re-releasing it now, and HD-ifying it, or whatever you want to call it, serves to only make it look even better, because it looks even sharper, and it makes the colors and all that kind of stuff pop out better. That's the main thing, I think, and that's why I think it's worthwhile like that. It's also on the computer, too, before I forget to mention it. If you've never played Okami before, I highly recommend getting it like this Okami HD, because it's absolutely fantastic. Or get the Wii version if you want to play it with motion control, which actually works very well on that. But I can't complain with this at all. Any of the kind of changes that were made were not significant. It's pretty much the same game. And it's also on the PlayStation 3. There you go, in case you're wondering. You can find this stuff out on your own if you want. But not much else I can complain about. Although it is kind of useless. You can use the touchpad on the PlayStation 4 to sort of move the brush when you're painting. It's not big enough for that, and it doesn't really recognize what you're doing that well. It's better to just use the sticks. I'm not saying it's a complaint, it's just something I noticed. It's kind of pointless, why bother? Just use the sticks, it works a lot better. Very fun game, though. If you've never played it, go for it. Like I said, one of my favorite games on the PlayStation 2. It was great. I didn't know jack what the hell it was when I saw it originally. All I knew is, really pretty art, I have to play it. And, oh, you know something else that makes me happy with this? Was the price. It was $20 new. That's what things like this should be when they redo whatever a game like this. So yeah, very great game, really cool music too. If you've never played it, go for it. It's great. It costs jack. A new game, quote unquote new game, that costs way less than what new games go for, and it's great. So what's to complain about? Alright, I went on way too long, but that's because I wanted to talk about certain things and explain stuff. I think I slipped up some stuff, but like I said, I'm out of practice with this. I said I wasn't going to do these anymore, and I still kind of stand by that, but I at least wanted to do this one, so I don't know, there you go. If I do another one again, maybe, we'll see, but it's going to be quite a long while because I'm not really getting much games lately, intentionally. So there you go, that's it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in whatever video I do next. Later.